Good afternoon, everyone. This is Vinod from Excel Snippet. This is our third video on our Excel Snippet quick view series. And today we are about to see how to work with R function, a logical test, inside an if condition. So when I go for a logical test, normally what is an if and or condition does for us? When I say if is used to compare a data. If the value is gonna come as true, then it's gonna give you a particular value that we specify. And if the value is false, then it's gonna specify the other value that is relevant to the functionality. When you use an OR condition, and again, if I have more than one logical test in my system, then I can convert that logical tests into a desirable results. That's what an OR condition can do. If any one condition satisfies our need, it is going to give you the conditional concept as true. So let's see how to work with this in a simple example. When I go to a simple example, normally when I talk about OR condition, and again, I'll be getting the following dimensions when I try to connect two different conditions. When I have condition one and condition two, if both the conditions satisfies my need, then my all argument will become true. If that is the case, then my result will also be true. And this will be the case even if I have a true for the first condition, false for the second condition, or true for the first conditions and false for the second conditions, and false for the first conditions and true for the second conditions, and so on. If all my values are false, then it will give you an answer called false. Let's see how to work on this point. So I have a condition here, so I'm going to do both these formula one by one. My first formula that I'm going to do is, when I normally give a logical test, I don't even need any of these two functions. Neither an OR nor an F is required. Normal logical test is a cell reference based point. For example, I want to give two conditions in a logical test. That is impossible for us to do. I can able to give any one condition here. For example, if I'm looking for only one condition to satisfy here, then I'll say equals. If this is equal to male, then I can get the answer as true. And if I populate this throughout, and it's going to show you a multiple dimension here, I'm going to keep that male that I've selected on the L15, and I'm going to log them as absolute reference by pressing F4 once. When I give an enter, now you can see that wherever my answer is satisfied, it is going to give you an answer called true. Wherever the answer is not satisfied, it's going to give you a false. So a normal logical test may not able to acquire more than one condition given to us. Wherein when I go to an OR condition, in an OR condition, I can add 255 conditions inside, or a 255 logical test inside a single OR condition. So I'm going to give an equals and an R. And when I give a control A, you can see that I get logical test one. And when I keep pressing this tab until last line, it goes until 255 logical test. This number of logical tests can be added in a single OR condition, but we are looking for only two conditions here. The condition we mentioned in here is, if the age is 30 and above, and if the sex is male, then I want whether it is a true or false. So I'm going to take two conditions here. I'm going to give OR condition first. I'm going to say in the sex, whether it is equal to male, and then I'm going to absolute cell reference this condition called male on the right hand side, give a comma. Then if the age of the person is greater than 30, then I want to even give an absolute cell reference for the age 30 and close the bracket and give an enter. Now we can see that I got my answer satisfied. In my last condition, neither my age is 30 nor my sex is male. Whereas the third condition has one condition, both the conditions satisfied. The first condition, both the conditions satisfied. And the second condition, the first condition is satisfied, whereas the second condition is not satisfied. As I'm using OR condition, if any one condition satisfies here, automatically my answer will come into play. Now I want to mention this as my condition satisfied. If it is true, And if my condition is not satisfied, I'm going to call that as not satisfied. So I'm going to just say equals, copy and paste this formula here. So select the, press an F2 here, and then select the whole formula, copy it and paste it here, and add an if. And at last, I'm going to give a comma and say satisfied. And I'm going to say not satisfied. So wherever my answer got satisfied, I can see my output will give us the logic called satisfied. Wherever the answer is not satisfied, it's going to give you the answer called not satisfied. So I've used an OR condition first, and then I used an if condition at last. If you want to showcase this formula, if you are using Office 2016 and above, then you have a formula called formula text. And when I give an enter, you can see what is the formula that I wrote inside my results. So this is the first formula which I mentioned my OR conditions. And this is the formula that I mentioned with an OR inside, and outside I've added a if condition so that it gives you the satisfied or not according to the output of the transaction. In the same way, when I get more than two transactions, for example, if you see, I have a set of customers with me, and I want to see whether the customers are requesting the bankers to extend their credit. So I'm going to use an OR condition first, and then later on, if I get a true or false, based on that, I'm going to give an if at last and say whether I'm going to extend it or not. So I'm going to give an equals first and OR. I'm going to say if my credit rating 1 is greater than or equal to 6, and I want this condition satisfied for all my customers. So I'm going to give an absolute cell reference here, F4 once. Then I give a comma, and if this is greater than the second condition, and F4 again once, then this is greater than or equal to this condition, F4 once, and close the bracket and give an enter. Now you can see you'll get, wherever we have at least one condition is satisfied, I'll get it true. If I don't get one condition satisfied, at least the rest of the condition, if all the conditions are false, then I'll give or get an answer called false. Now I'm going to copy this formula and then paste it here, and then add an if at last, and then I give a comma here and give a double quotes here. I say extend credit, and I say don't extend credit. Then I populate this formula throughout. If I want to see the formulas here, I'm going to say formula text and formula text. Merge them, make it bold. Excuse me. So this is the way we will deal with and an OR condition, or OR condition inside an if formula. So I've used OR function inside an if formula. We call this as inside out method. Hope you learned something new today, and this is Vinod signing out from Excel Snippet. If you're not subscribed my channel, please do subscribe it. Like yesterday, I've added 2 videos. Today I've added 1 more. I'll be adding another video very soon, so you'll be getting 1 more video where I try to put a comparison video on an OR condition with a new condition which is introduced in 2013 version called XOR condition. Hope you enjoy my video. If you don't subscribe to my channel yet, please do subscribe my channel. And I'm just one shot for my 50th video, and the 50th video will be on OR versus XOR function. Thank you so much. Have a good day.